us and we're going to hunt for moose. With pork and onions in our packs and the dogs are running loose. Well, we headed in for Frenchman's Hill, a cabin we would stay. We tied the dogs and bed them down, then we hit the hay. Bernard started telling jokes and I couldn't get to sleep. So I filled the stove with firewood and it passed out from the heat. Eddie lay there snoring, sweat it fell like rain. And the snores that came from Kevin John were making my ears pain. Next morning before breakfast, well, I untied my dog. And he headed straight for Juno's, there was something on the bog. Frank untied the other dogs, you should have seen them go. Why, they ran just like greased lightning, and they hardly touched the snow. We grabbed our guns, jumped in our boots, and headed down the trail. And all hands in their underwear, and looking mighty pale. Well, we finally made it to the bog, though we didn't have a light. And the dogs were barking at a moose, he was almost dead from fright. Shots rang out that morning and the moose lay on the bog. Well, we opened up and bled her, 'twas a feast for every dog. Then back to camp for breakfast, we had liver, pork and paste. And Stanley made the gravy like you'd never taste. 'Twas but a short time later that we went down with our packs. Little did we realize what we carry in our packs. And then we saw her colors, which the dark did not allow. And there upon Big Juno's bog lay Pie Slade's cow. Now the moral of this story is, don't shoot in the night, 'cause you may go to prison if you don't see the light. And if you go hunting and your dogs are on the loose, well, you better make sure it's daybreak before you shoot your moose.